in a few hours. We can communicate with people living in thousands of kilometers away in seconds. All these have been made possible by modern means of transport and communication system. So let us discuss transport and communications. What is transport? Transport is the movement of any goods from one place to another place. Early humans traveled on foot and then they invented wheels and started making cars. These were pulled by animals. However, these were slow modes of transport which can cover a longer distances in very less time. A good transportation system results in economic growth of a region. So we have important modes of transport. The different modes of transport include on land, roadways, railways, on water, waterways, on air, airways. Let us discuss roadways. Transport on land is called roadways. Roads are the most important and commonly used of transportation in the world. Roads provided door-to-door transfer of people and goods from one place to another. Roads are either metalled or unmetalled. Metalled roads, in cities and towns, they are called metalled. It is also called pakka roads. These roads are made of cement, stone and tar. Unmetalled roads are generally found in villages. These are made of stone and mud. So it is also called kaccha roads. In India, we have important roads. They are the national highways and the state highways. The national highways connect state capital and big cities and towns. The state highways connect cities and towns in the state. The national highways are constructed and maintained by the central government. The state highways are maintained by the state government. In India, we have three main national highways. They are Golden Quadrilateral Highways. See children, this is the Golden Quadrilateral Highway. See properly. And then East-West Corridor Highway. See, so this is the East-West Corridor Highway. And North-South Corridor Highway. It starts from Srinagar and to the Kanyakumari in South. So children, this is the longest national highway in India. Next comes railways. Railways are the lifeline of our country. They connect all parts of India. At the time of independence, trains were run by steam engines. These were replaced by diesel and electric engines. It increased speed of trains. India has a well developed, a large network of railways. Railways provided largely employment opportunities for both skilled and unskilled labor. In some cities, there are metro trains. These were elevated or underground tracks. So there are some metro trains in Mumbai, Chennai, Kolkata, Delhi and Noida. Indian Railways is the second largest railway network in India and the fourth largest railway network in entire world. So next comes waterways. It is the cheapest mode of transport and most suitable for transporting heavy goods to at low rates to coastal regions. National, international trade also benefits largely from this mode of transport. In India, we have three types of ships. Passenger ships carry people, cargo ships carry goods, and tanker ships carry oil and petroleum. Along the India's coastline, there are 13 major ports and 200 minor ports. So Mumbai is the biggest port in India. In India, we have major ports. They are Kandla Port in Gujarat. Then down you have Mumbai Port in Maharashtra. Then Mann Goa Port in Goa. Down you have Kochi Port in Kerala. And here Tuticorin Port in Tamil Nadu. Then Ennore Port in Andhra Pradesh. Then Visakhapatnam in Odisha. Paradip Port in Odisha. Then last one, Kolkata Port in West Bengal. So children, these are major ports in India. Next comes airways. Airways are the fastest means of transport and it is the most expensive one as well. Airways suitable for carry people who want a lot of comfort and convenience. Airways help in transport high value and time sensitive goods like sophisticated machines, sophisticated means delicate, and costly drugs, then perishable goods. Perishable goods like fresh fruits, exotic flowers and vegetables. Both government and private airlines operate in our country. Helicopters are used in areas that are difficult to reach. It is also used in drop food and medicines. And it is used in rescue people during natural disasters. So next comes communications. Sending and receiving messages is called communications. Long ago, messages took many days or weeks to reach, but nowadays messages can send reach in seconds. In the major important communications are postal service, telephone, fax, internet and email, radio, television, newspapers and magazines. So let us discuss more about these. So first one, postal service. India's postal service is called India Post. It is the largest of it is the largest postal network of in India. People buy letters, postcards, stamps, envelope letters from the post office. We can send letters and parcels through post office. So next comes telephone. We can talk to people in any part of the world with the help of telephone. Landline phones have been replaced by mobile phones. Most of the people use mobile phones and smartphones. It is a very useful or all-in-one devices with which can do many things. So next comes fax. A written document can be sent through a fax machine. It takes only a few seconds to reach. So next, internet and email. Internet and email are the important communication system. Internet usage is expanding its boundaries every day as the technological growth is huge. E-commerce, e-learning, then social connectivity, then varieties of media, etc. Next comes radio. It is a very useful for people who cannot read and write. A program on radio reaches all corners of the India. All India Radio broadcasts news and educational programs in many languages. Next comes television. It is a very important communication system. Television is a source of entertainment. Today's modern society, media has become very good part of our life. Its duty is to educate, to inform, and to entertainment. Next comes newspapers and magazines. A large number of newspapers and magazines are published in India. Newspapers and magazines carry news and information about events from all parts of the world. Some people read e-newspaper